Hello there, YouTube, and welcome to a random review. I am Random Ross, and now the series is over, I'm reviewing WandaVision. So this is a Disney Plus original series that is directed by Matt Shakman, starring Elizabeth Olson, Paul Bettany, Deborah Jo Rupp, Fred Melamendosma, Catherine Haim, Randall Park, Tiano Paris, Kat Dennings, and Evan Peters. So this follows, this takes place 3 weeks after the events of Avengers Endgame, where Wanda Maximoff and Vision are living an idyllic suburban life in the town of Westview, New Jersey, trying to conceal their true nature as they begin to enter a new decade and encounter television tropes that the couple suspect that things are not as they seem. So that is the premise of the series. So there's 9 episodes, and yeah, so let's get on to our likes and dislikes. So first of all, the likes. I like this series. I thought it was going to be a bit dull, and I'll be honest, it did start off a bit dull, but it got better. It got up there. It got better as each episode went on. The first 2 episodes I thought were a bit dull. They were classic sitcoms. You know, each episode was set in a decade. We had it starting in the 50s and the 60s and the 70s and the 80s and 90s and 2000s, all the way to the present, well, the 2020s. And we also discover that Wanda and Vision's nosy neighbour, Agnes, is actually the witch, Agatha Harkness, who's also been partly doing all the evil stuff. We also find out, as the series goes on, that Wanda, out of her grief, creates this reality with her powers and brings Vision back. And, of course, Sword, yes, she'll no more Sword, is on this, and they're trying to stop her from doing the Hex. This is all led by director Tyler Hayward, who wants to destroy Wanda because he sees her as a great threat. We also get some old faces returning this. We get Agent Jimmy Woo from Ant-Man and the Wasp. We get Darcy Lewis from Thor and Thor the Dark World. And we get Monica Rambeau, now a grown woman, from Captain Marvel. In this too, as side characters who want to help Wanda. We even get Pietro. We find out that he's a fake Pietro because, it's Evan Peters. When I had the feeling they were going to bring him into it, I thought, is it Pietro? But it wasn't the one we were expecting. But still, it's all revealed in time what's really going on. That's another thing. As the episodes go on, it gets revealed what's really going on. We get all the loose ends tied. So I like that we get to find that out eventually, that they, explain what's really going on with the Hex, and I liked that. This had about 9 episodes to it, and let's just say they got better as they went on. I'll say that much, and I enjoyed it. I really loved Elizabeth Olsen back as Wanda, and in this she finally gets called the Scarlet Witch, as she is meant to be a powerful witch or something that was prophesied, that was given her powers, and that from the Mind Stone, of course. And I liked that. I liked that she finally looked more like her comic book counterpart in this. I also like Paul Bettany as Vision, as a different kind of Vision, as we find out later on in the series. She also has twins in this, 2 twin sons, which play an important role, which I think will eventually play an important role, because like I say, she gains the ability to bend reality around her. So, maybe if they do a second season, we might see all that again. And will we get a second season? I really hope so. I think we should at least get one after the post-credit scene. Now, there are post-credit scenes like in the Marvel movies. There's a mid-credit scene in some of them, but in the final episode, we get a mid-credit and a post-credit scene, so we sure to stick around for them. Yeah, this was a good series. It got off to a low start, but it soon picked up, and I enjoyed it. I really, enjoyed this series, and I do recommend it. Some dislikes I have, though, are that the credits. Now, this is like a half-hour episode, but then we have like 10 minutes of like credits rolling, like as if it's a film. We do get some, mid-credit scenes. But yeah, I like that it was all set up like a domestic sitcom, but then it all unraveled and revealed to just be all from Wanda. I did have theories at first, like thinking could she be in an assimilation or something from Hydra or something, but no, that wasn't the case. But WandaVision, do I recommend this? Yes, I do, and I say check it out if you're a Marvel fan. It's kicked off Phase 4 greatly. I mean, Black Widow was originally meant to kick off Phase 4, but of course with this pandemic, it's had to be pushed back and stuff. But yeah, I think, starting Phase 4 of a series is not that bad. So, my ratings, I'll give WandaVision 4 out of 5. 4 out of 5 for WandaVision. So there you go, that's my review on that. So have you seen this one? Let me know down in the comments below if you have. If you like this video, be sure to give it a big thumbs up, share with your friends. Feel free to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already and to hit that notification bell. All of my social media links are linked down below in the description so you can check all that out. I also have two other channels if you're interested in horror or Doctor Who or science fiction. They're linked to down below or in the cards above. So yeah, be sure to check all that out. I've been Random Ross. This has been a Random Review, and until next time, I bid you all a goodbye, friends. Goodbye.